with them in their happiness and witness them take their marriage vows. This historical setting was once the hunting lodge of the Duke of Hamilton, and in keeping with the building, Daniel and Emma have chosen a civil ceremony, which is the oldest form of marriage known in Scotland. From time to time as a registrar, I conduct ceremonies with just a couple of other witnesses present, and while that can be special in its own way, it is so very nice when family and friends come along to give a couple support on such an important day in their lives. Indeed, I may be the only person present this morning that you've not met before. I'm Lawyer Cooper, and I'm a registrar for the District of South Lanarkshire, and I'm authorised to conduct civil marriages. Before a civil marriage can proceed, there are certain requirements that have to be observed. This, as Emma and Daniel know, require them to complete marriage notice forms and submit these together with various documents. As I am in possession of the marriage schedule, I'm satisfied there have been no objections to your marriage, and I'm happy to proceed with today's ceremony. I would like to say that although the civil marriage ceremony is fairly short, it is no less binding in character than any other form of marriage. Daniel and Emma will, in a few minutes' time, make their declarations before me and their witnesses. By their declarations, they declare their freedom to marry and their acceptance of one another as husband and wife. We will then seal the contract of marriage by the giving and receiving of rings. I will then declare them to be husband and wife. And finally, we sign the marriage schedule, the document of marriage. Once we have signed the marriage schedule, Daniel and Emma will be as legally married by this ceremony as any other they could have chosen. Marriage, according to the law of Scotland, is the union of one man and one woman, voluntarily entered into, to the exclusion of all others. Marriage should not be entered into lightly, nor taken for granted. It is formed upon sincerity and trust, having respect for each other's individual needs and accepting one another's faults and weaknesses. Marriage is a journey, not an arrival. It is a creative process, requiring thought and effort. It is the joining of two hearts and souls. It is being your own person whilst appreciating you are part of another. Before Daniel and Emma make their declarations, could I invite Sarah forward to give the first reading?
The hope of this. A marriage between two, a joining of two hearts, a joining of hope for the future, a love that will never be apart. As you stand before us on this special day, we wish you all the love in the world. We wish you happiness for you both to share. May your dreams be fulfilled and life be without care.
Daniel, the legal impediments to marriage have already been explained to you. Could you please repeat the following declaration after me, please? In the presence of our family and friends.
In the presence of our family and friends.
I, Daniel James Cantley.
I, Daniel James Cantley.
Truly declare.
Truly declare.
That I know of no legal reason.
That I know of no legal reason.
As to why.
As to why.
I should not be joined in marriage.
I should not be joined in marriage.
To you, Emma Louise Parsons.
To you, Emma Louise Parsons.
On this, our special day.
On this, our special day.
I accept you, Emma.
I accept you, Emma.
As my lawful wedded wife.
As my lawful wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
For the rest of our lives.
For the rest of our lives.
Emma, I'd ask you to make the same declaration, please.
I thought you were going to go there.
In the presence of our family and friends.
In the presence of our family and friends.
I, Emma Louise Parsons.
I, Emma Louise Parsons.
Truly declare.
Truly declare.
That I know of no legal reason.
That I know of no legal reason.
As to why.
As to why.
I should not be joined in marriage.
I should not be joined in marriage.
To you, Daniel James Cantley.
To you, Daniel James Cantley.
On this, our special day.
On this, our special day.
I accept you, Daniel.
I accept you, Daniel.
As my lawful wedded husband.
As my lawful wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
For the rest of our lives.
For the rest of our lives.
We have now come to the giving of the wedding rings. The exchanging of rings is not a legal requirement in Scotland, however it has become a tradition. The ring was chosen as a symbol of marriage because of its shape. Being round, it has no beginning and no end, and therefore represents your constant and everlasting love for each other. Could I ask you to give Daniel energy, please?
Thanks, buddy.
Daniel, as you place the ring on the third finger of Emma's left hand, if you repeat after me, I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a sign of my love and affection.
As a sign of my love and affection.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I have, I share with you.
All that I have, I share with you.
And Emma, if you repeat after me, I accept this ring.
I accept this ring.
And in return.
And in return.
I give you my love.
I give you my love.
Put it on?
Yeah. And if you could get Daniel right to Emma. Emma, as you place the ring on Daniel's finger, if you could repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a sign of my love and affection.
As a sign of my love and affection.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I have, I share with you.
All that I have, I share with you.
And Daniel, if you accept the ring, I accept this ring.
I accept this ring.
And in return.
And in return.
I give you my love.
I give you my love.
These rings are a symbol of unity in which your lives are now joined in one unbroken cycle. Your wedding rings declare that, even in your uniqueness, you have chosen to be together, allowing the presence of another human being to enhance who you are and who you will become. May these rings always remind you of the love you share and of the promises made to each other today. Daniel and Emma, following the binding vows which you have made before me, your family and friends and your witnesses, it now gives me the greatest of pleasure to pronounce you husband and wife. Daniel, you may kiss your friend.